Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to your video on fractions and percents. After today, you should be able to write fractions as percents, percents as fractions, and then also know the word ratios and how that relates to fractions and percents as well. So stop and think about what you know about what can we use to represent parts of wholes. So think about this, and you're going to have some vocabulary coming up. What can we use to represent parts of wholes? So example, how you do on a test. The whole test is the score. What part you make is the number you earn, and so on and so forth. So think about what other ways, what other situations are there to represent parts of wholes. A ratio. A ratio is a comparison of two quantities by division. Ratios can be written as, like, say, for example, if I score 9 out of 100. 9 out of 100. 9 to 100 with a colon there. Or as a fraction, 9 out of 100, 9 one-hundredths. So these are all ratios. This is just showing a comparison of quantities by division. So those are different ways that ratio, then you notice, is also a fraction. Because a fraction is a comparison of two numbers. So a lot of times on your tests or quizzes, you see that you scored maybe a 2 out of 3. That means you had 2. That was the part you got right out of the 3, out of the whole number of them. Okay? So percents, then, percents are ratios that are compared to 100. So a ratio that is compared to 100 can be written as a percent. So for example, if I said 9 out of 100, that is the same as 9%. Because what you'll notice is that percent, a percent, is read as per cent, where cent means 100. Okay, so per 100. So percent again, a percent is a part of a whole of a ratio that compares to 100. So whenever you see a fraction out of 100, that's really the same as that number as a percent seen here. A lot of vocabulary. Make sure you're writing these things down and trying to get a good understanding what a ratio is, a comparison of two numbers by division, and a percent is when it's written with a percent symbol, it's out of 100. Fractions and percents are ratios that can be represent the same number. So fractions can be equal to percents, which we also saw as decimals. So both of them are ratios, you know, something like this, out of 100, that can compare the same numbers. So we're going to practice writing a fraction as a percent. So for example, if I'm asked to write 3/20 as a percent, well, percents I know are per 100. Last time I learned about making fractions equivalent by just changing them. So I want this one to be out of 100, but not changing the value. I'm keeping them equal. So I can change 20 to get to 100 by multiplying by 5. 3 times 5 is 15. So that means that 3/20 is the same as 15/100, which percent per 100 is the same as 15%. So 3/20 is equivalent to 15%. Try these on your own. So it's making fractions with a denominator of 100, and then writing them as a percent. So 17/20, if I want the denominator to be 100, I have to multiply both the numerator and the denominator by 5. So I get 85 over 100. Which is the same as 85%. Three-fifths, I want to make an equivalent fraction out of 100. So I multiply both the top and the bottom by 20. So I get 60/100, which is the same as 60%. 2/25. To get this to 100 as a denominator, I multiply the numerator and denominator by 4. for 8 one-hundredths, which is 8%. Not too bad. So ratios are fractions. So what I'd like us to do is write each ratio as a percent. So ratios are fractions. So we are going to do that. So if we had a ratio of 3 out of 50 books read, that's the same as writing it as a fraction, 3 out of 50. Changing that by a factor of 2, and we get 60 out of 100. So that means 60% of the total books were read. 12 out of 25 teenagers. So then we change that, factor 4, to get 48 hundredths. So that means that there are 48% of teenagers doing something. 12 and 2 tenths out of 100 points earned. So that's the same as or equivalent to 12 and 2 tenths percent points earned. And 11 feet out of 20 feet, 11 over 20, change by a factor of 5. For 55 out of 100, which is the equivalent to 55% of feet. So a couple more, and this is pretty quick and easy, back and forth, changing if we know per 100. So now you're going to be asked to write the percent as a fraction, remembering that percent is per 100 and a number over 100, whatever the percent is. So if I have 48%, that's 48 hundredths. But we want them in simplest form, so we go back to finding our greatest common factor to divide by. So I for sure know, maybe I don't do my greatest, but I know both of these share a factor of 4. So I have 12 25ths. Those share a greatest common factor of 1, so it's simplified. That means 48% is equal to 12 25ths. Give these a try and then you're set. 40%, that's 40. Percent means 100. These are both even, so they share a factor of 2, but I also know that they share a factor of 4. And I guess they had another factor in mind as well. They could have shared 5, so I divide by 5 again. So again, this one I didn't pick my greatest common factor, but I am picking factors. So then 10 divided by 5 is 2, 25 divided by 5 is 5. So that means if I divided by 4 and by 5, my greatest common factor I could have divided by was 20. And this means that 40% is the same as 2/5. 6% is 6 out of 100, sharing a factor of 2 for 3/50. 6% is the same as 3/50. 24% or 24 per 100, they share a factor of 4 for 6/25. They do not share any factors other than 1, so 24% is equal to 6/25. Yay! Go back and watch what you need to, look at examples in the book. Really just make sure you're aware that we're looking for equivalent things here. Fractions and ratios can be written as percents, and they all represent parts of wholes. Good luck. See you soon.